up, folks, and welcome to another edition of the Cardinal Review. I am the Cardinal, and we will be reviewing something today, right now, in fact. And that game, that thing, it's a game, I already said it, I spoiled the whole thing, is Devil May Cry 5. I have beaten this game twice because I hated it so much I had to play it two times on two different systems. Yes, I, in a rare case of fever insanity, I played this game on both the PS4 Pro and the Xbox One S, because I don't have an X, because I don't have $500, okay? So get out of my face. Anyways, so let's start with the visuals, because that's a good place to start, right? The visuals in this game, it uses the RE engine, which is also used in, I mean, I'm sure you probably can't tell, Resident Evil. RE may stand for Resident Evil. We don't know. No one could know. You might have to Google it, but you may not find what you're looking for. Or you probably will. So, the graphics, as you can tell by my other video where I thought the graphics in Resident Evil were so good, it made me want to kill myself. Like, in a good way. Like a poetic way, not like in a real way. Then, I started thinking, man, what could be better than these Resident Evil graphics that are so graphically good? And then I saw this game, and I'm like, oh my god, in Resident Evil, all they have are guns. In this game, they have guns and swords. Man, guns and sword. Did you even hear what I just said? Guns and swords. Let me take you back for a second. Little Robbie from the 2000s, the early 2000s. I was in a room very much like this room, and I was living in that room because I was a child, and someone had let me borrow their PS2, and I was like, PS2, whatever, bro, I'm a Nintendo boy, GameCube for life, mother effer. And they were like, just borrow this thing and play this one game. It's so cool and game-like that it will blow your little gamey mind. And I was like, whatever, bro. Mario and Zelda for life. And I still think that. So don't think I'm like tripping on you. You know what I'm saying? I'm wearing a Breath of the Wild hoodie. So chill out. So I played this game called Devil May Cry over the weekend, right? It blew my face hole out of my brain hole. I mean, I never knew a game could be so dope, so magnificently insane and stupid and hilarious and amazing. It was like I was watching Star Wars meets Deadpool, and I wanted to kill myself all over again, in the good way, again. Jeez Louise, Peppa Cheese, this game was insane because, again, the first time I ever saw a game where you could use guns and swords. I'm gonna say that one more time, you guys, because I really don't think you heard me. Guns and swords. Yes, and everyone's probably going, in Final Fantasy VIII, fuck off, okay? The gun blade, it wasn't a gun, okay? It was a sword that looked like a gun, and yes, it could use a power that sort of shot things, but you never saw the blade come off. You never actually saw him really shoot it. Like, really shoot it. Like, don't at me, okay, on Twitters, because I don't have a Twitter, because I don't know how to work the internet. I barely know how to use this YouTube thing. Anyways, so I'm sorry for that long detour into my past, but now we are back. Devil May Cry 5. I played 2, it was terrible. They ruined us. Then 3 came out, and it was pretty good, and it was really good. And then 4 came out, and it was this big backtracky kind of thing, and it sort of lost me a little bit. DMC came out, and that was a weird, like, try to be too edgy thing. This game, though, this is the Devil May Cry I was waiting for. And it all started with that visual flair. The first time I saw that game running, I was like, oh my god, dude. The guns, the swords, this looks dope! And this game, like I said before, remember how I said Resident Evil 4, Resident Evil 2, the remake, is running on the RE engine, and I said, it was the best graphics I had seen, or something like that. I'm quoting myself. In my brain, I sound like a Shakespearean character when I think of my past. That's how I work. But no, when I thought that Resident Evil looked good, well, I was only looking at those graphics in 30 frames per second. This time, friends, this time I was looking at the same graphics, but a man holding a gun, holding a sword, 60 frames per second. I said it, yeah, the whole damn game. How is that even possible? I don't know. The game looks just as good as Resident Evil 2, but it's in 60 frames per second. And you're flying around, killing the demon boys. As I thought, Resident Evil 2 looks so good because it's in these closed off environments and it has this slow, methodical kind of pace to it. This game doesn't have a slow, I mean, yes, the environments aren't super open either. Very closed, I mean. But my goodness, what a beautiful game. And it stars three beautiful boys named Dante and Trevor and Richard. Those not the names. Dante, V, and Nelson. Nico. Those are the three characters. You think I played this game twice. And you think I'd be better at remembering the names of the people, but they all just, I mean, there's like a Nico and a Nero. I mean, come on. I mean, what's going on? So anyways, yes. Let's sum it all up. The graphics are really, really good. Some of the best I've ever seen. And boy, do these handsome boys look so great in their sheeny, nice, wonderful 60 frame per second RE engine of wonderfulness. So yes, graphics are amazing. Some of the best I've ever seen. Now, sound. The music is fantastic. It is wonderful. It is the best music I've heard in the last week. Now granted, that is the only music I've heard in the last week, but it is the best. It's very good. There's some cool poppy, metal-y stuff. There's this one song, it's like, bang, 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 my devil trigger. The voice acting's fine. It's sort of cheesy, but it's supposed to be. I mean, it's kind of got that like Deadpool-y kind of sense of humor, but then it gets serious sometimes. But it's all sort of fun, you know what I'm saying? Dante calls the character V, who can summon this bird. He calls him a chicken. Everybody calls him a chicken. It's funny, whatever. The dialogue is moderately well done. The music is very well done. The sound effects are also very well done. One cool thing is the music gets going better the better you do. So if you're like doing not great, like say you're just like, poosh, I don't know how to do combos, and you're just like D rank, it's just you're slashing up a dude, you're not doing very good, you're getting your ass kicked, the music's gonna be like, but then you start doing better, and the better you get, the music starts ramping up, and you get to B, it's like, and then you get to A, and it's like, and then you get to S rank, and you start getting to triple S, and that's when that song flips, gets going, and it's like, bang, 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 my devil trigger, and it's like, fucking lyrics come out of nowhere, and they start hitting you, and it's amazing. So anyways, the sound, fantastic, overall, you know? And that brings me to gameplay. It's gameplay, you play as one of three dudes. At the beginning, you're forced to play as Nero, who is a man who has lost his arm and he has to use a mega buster type thing that can explode and kill people if you want to do that. It's cool. You load them into a magazine. I wish that you could switch between them, but you have to like destroy one in order to use the next one. But each one has its own unique powers. There's even an actual mega buster in the game. I have a mega buster. I was looking for it in my room, couldn't tell. But it's pretty cool. Thing I like about Nero the most, though, is he has this little rope thing part of his arm that can pull enemies towards him or pull himself towards enemies and slash and shit their face off. And then he slices and dices. He's got one gun. He's probably the most standard of the characters, like the most hack and slashy standard guy. Then you have V, who's this really emo Pokemon trainer, where he doesn't fight at all. He just sort of sits back, is like, psh, whatever. He's got a bird named Griffin. He's got a panther named Shadow. And he has this giant beast named Sam. Nightmare. That's his name. His name is Nightmare. And he's awesome. And they just kick ass together. They're a bunch of bros, man. He's bros with his bros, and they like hang out. He fucking sits back. He like reads this book. You can literally read a book. There's a button to read a book. I've been waiting my whole life. You understand how long I've been waiting to fucking to have a game where I got a button and I can just read a book. It's just reading a book. And while you're reading the book, your gauges are going up. Your nightmare. Nightmare is your ultimate, right? So your triangle controls the panther, which is like close-up attacks, the shadow. And then your square controls the raven, the bird, the griffin, and he's like shooting lasers. He's the laser raven. Laser raven? Band name. I call it. You can't take it. You can have it. And then Nightmare is like his ultimate, so he summons this fucking giant dude. He like comes down in a comet, and he's just like, oh, fucking badass. And sometimes you fight enemies that are like the same size as Nightmare, and they like, he does, when he finishes them off, they do this like Colossus battle thing, and you like ride on top of him. It's, oh man, it's so dope. This game is just dope. The whole thing is just, I mean, I'm not a young kid, and maybe I can't use that word. Maybe that's y'all's word, but I'm not young, but I'm gonna use it. It's dope. That whole shit is dope. The shiz is dopeies. Oh, I don't sound cool. So anyways, so Robin, the graphics are great. The sound is great. The gameplay is great. Well, I forgot one character. His name is Dante, and he's like he's the thesis of the whole game. He is the man of the hour. He's the one you've been waiting to play as, and you don't unlock him until about halfway through the game. But once you do, of course, he has all the things, right? He's got all the stuffs. He has the most different ways of playing him. You can play him as this dodgy, crazy man, like the trickster. He has different stances. And you can play the sword master. He uses a sword all badass. You can use him like a fucking bullet dude. And he has like a badass trick shot. And you can just switch between the fucking fly. And I've seen people online go insane with this game. The combos you can do. I'm pretty decent. I think I am. I've beaten it twice. I beat it on the hardest difficulty because I'm hard. So I'm hard like that, you know? Tell your friends that I am hard. That I go pretty hard. No, my producer's telling me, no, I'm not hard. But anyways, I just wanna say, man, I cannot even decide which character I like to play as the most. The hardest part of this whole game, hardest part of reviewing it, was like literally the missions where you could pick between Dante, V, or Nero. I was just sitting there going, I don't know, just pick for me. I don't wanna have to pick, because they're all fun in their own way. And then of course, every action game, it kind of feels like that, like a Platinum game, or Platinum games feel like Devil May Cry. I don't know which one was first. Maybe probably Devil May Cry. It feels so badass. And then you get to the, it's got that Kingdom Heartsy thing, you know? If you know what I'm talking about, where like, the boss battles are just retarded. They're not, like, sometimes they don't even make sense, but it doesn't matter. It does not matter. It's just so badass. The music is going insane. Like this song right here. Like, this is going on. It's going right here. You're battling this dude. And then, like, shit's just going crazy. Nothing makes any sense. Who gives a fuck? Because this whole game is just amazing. Devil May Cry 5 is my favorite game of the year so far, slightly over Kingdom Hearts and slightly over Resident Evil. It's really good. So if you love yourself and you love games that are good at being games, and you like to laugh and you like to cry and you like to act like a godly badass with a sword and pistol or a gun, if you want to do that, if you want to just rock and roll around with a sword and a gun, you do that, son. You go get you some Devil May Cry 5, because it is worth it. And you are worth it, son. Treat yourself. This has been an episode of The Cardinal Review. Thank you for liking and subscribing. And maybe Ring the bell.